Welcome to the call. Oh, hi, Lema. And today we're going to talk about my current situation. And. Tagaho. Oh, hi, Lema. We are here today in the call to talk about my current situation and how I'm dealing with my injury during this time. So guys, as everybody knows, I got injured in mid of 21, and unfortunately I turned my Achilles tendon, and right now we're doing some treatments dealing with the injury. It's a bit of tough time as everybody across now because the situation, the virus situation also around us, but I'm doing some treatments, recovering with my physios and training by myself to get back as soon as possible. And has been around 3 to 4 months. I'm dealing with this injury. It's a tough one. And I hope I can get even better and better from when I did the surgery in June and start training again on January or February to can help team to play on February around. So that's it.
Okay, so lots of players will return to their country while they are injured. So why did you choose to stay in Hong Kong this time?
So I choose to stay in Hong Kong first of all because I have been here around almost 10 years, and in 2014. I left to get my knee surgery and start over in 15. So that is the last time from my project, personal project, when I wanted to become a local. And right now has more around 9 to 10 months to become local. And if everything goes well, as I'm planning, I expect to stay here to get my permanent ID card. And up in front, turn my passport to Hong Kong passport. And if, as I said, everything goes well, I hope to represent Hong Kong national team. This is my plan from when I arrived here in Hong Kong, 2011. And let's see if it can come through. It will be an amazing moment for me. Then, this is the why I choose to stay here.
Does it feel weird every day that you are with our club here because you're used to training with your teammates, now you are doing some personal treatments. You're on your own every day.
Yes, it's a bit weird not training every day because from very young kid, I'm training every day. And to reach this kind of level now to play as a professional football player, unfortunately, and we have to deal with injuries during our period of football players, but it's a bit weird because normally I have a team to train, have a team to play, and have a plan to come back, but some clubs are helping me here, and Rangers is the one who helped me to do my trainings, my treatments. Kevin Long, my physiotherapist, he's helping to do us his best. And I hope we can cross the situation the best as possible, best way as possible. Then I can come back playing and training normal as before.
So you now have some more free time than normal, I guess. Do you have explore anything else in Hong Kong during this period?
Yes, of course, I explored a bit of a few things. Nobody knows, but I did my high style when I was really young, my university. And when I was there, I tried to study physical education. Then my hope and my lovely thing, I was liking to do that during that time was teaching young kids. And during this time, sometimes when some schools or some football schools invite me, I do some lessons, some coaching stuff. Then it's my hobby to do that, for fun, of course. Then at the same time, I have to care about my injury, so I can't do that much. But I'm liking very much to have a contact with kids and sometimes meet some friends around who seem to give a coach lesson. Then that is my second thing I'd like to explore in Hong Kong, and was a good one.
So have you improved your Cantonese during this time?
Yes, I improve a lot. I don't know if everybody knows, but I even go to school sometimes to learn about that. Of course, it's tough. Everybody knows, especially for us from Brazil, who usually use the Latin versions of the language, like English, Spanish, and Portuguese. And from us, from the Chinese language, and Cantonese especially, it's the toughest language always, ever. Then I grew up with it, of course. I can speak. I understand much more than I speak. But as I said to everybody when I arrive here, have to get used to the people, how they live here, and have to show them some respect, because we are coming to their country. The country who can become my as well in a few months. It's a bit different to talk about like that, but you have to respect and try to get into their mind. And speaking the same language is going to be much more easy. So improve a bit, not bad.
Okay, so let's talk about the injury again. So injuries are part of football, and every player more or less has to deal with it sometime. So is it frustrating, especially you know that you are injured at the end of the season, last season?
Yes, it was a delicate situation at that time, because before the season finished, I got a really serious injuries, who after few weeks become the tendon tear, totally tear. And was very sad, because I know in that moment I can help my team very much to get maybe more trophies or get more winning games. And I was very sad to see everybody play, and was trying to get back as fast as possible, but was not enough time to get back. Then was very, very, very hard for me seeing everybody playing. And unfortunately, when I was in Easter, we lost the title and the league trophy in the last game. But it happened, and we have to step up on it, and looking forward for new challenges. And what going in the new football? You used to say you have a new chance every day. So it's okay. You just have to look forward for new challenges. Then you have to get the new chance that you will give to you and grab it with two hands and try to do as best as possible to get on track again.
Okay, so what type of mentality do you think players need to deal with their injury time?
The hardest thing during the injury time is dealing, as you said, three times, because you feel a bit useless, you know? You usually to go training, feel your body ready for everything, and you see the persons, you see the partners you play, your teammates, staff, coaches, you talk every day, and you feel useful, You know, you feel very nice. You can go there and they use you for something. But when you're not there, when you're alone sometimes, and it's that normal, you know. Nobody will keep saying, how are you? Or you feel bad, they will support you 100%. They have their own things to do and you have to understand. You know, I'm talking about any persons around. Then during this time, the hardest thing is just like be alone a bit, not involve our trainings, not involve tournaments or competitions. This is the hardest time. Then you have a lot of free time. You have to fill that time. You have to using that free time to do something who can put you up. That is what I'm doing sometimes. But this is the hard thing. When you usually doing everything and suddenly you have to stop, can't training, you feel not really useful, and it's not that good, but you have to handle it.